July 7th, Daily Video Bible Reading from the Net Bible, 2 Corinthians chapter 2 from the New Testament. So I made up my own mind not to pay you another painful visit. For if I make you sad, who would be left to make me glad but the one I caused to be sad? And I write this very thing to you so that when I came, I would not have sadness from those who ought to make me rejoice, since I am confident in you and all that my joy would be yours. For out of great distress and anguish of heart, I wrote to you with many tears, not to make you sad, but to let you know the love that I have especially for you. But if anyone has caused sadness, he has not saddened me alone, but to some extent, not to exaggerate, he has saddened all of you as well. This punishment on such an individual by the majority is enough for him, so that now instead you should rather forgive and comfort him. This will keep him from being overwhelmed by excessive grief to the point of despair. Therefore, I urge you to reaffirm your love for him. For this reason also, I wrote you, to test you to see if you are obedient in everything. If you forgive anyone for anything, I also forgive him. For indeed what I have forgiven, if I have forgiven anything, I did so for you in the presence of Christ, so that we may not be exploited by Satan, for we are not ignorant of his schemes. Now when I arrived in Troas to proclaim the gospel of Christ, even though the Lord had opened a door of opportunity for me, I had no relief in my spirit, because I did not find my brother Titus there. So I said goodbye to them and set out for Macedonia. But thanks be to God, who always leads us in triumphal procession in Christ, and who makes known through us the fragrance that consists of the knowledge of him in every place. For we are a sweet aroma of Christ to God among those who are being saved and among those who are perishing. To the latter, an odor from death to death, but to the former, a fragrance from life to life. And who is adequate for these things? For we are not like so many others, hucksters who peddle the word of God for profit, but we are speaking in Christ before God as persons of sincerity, as persons sent from God. God, in verse 16, Paul talks about who is sufficient for these things, who is adequate for these things. And we know that the gospel doesn't happen. The saving grace doesn't happen through us. It truly happens because of you, through you, at your choosing. We know that we are simply doing your will, telling other people about you, showing people who we are through our actions and our words. And then, as it says in John 15:16, you choose them, we don't choose you. God, please help us today to be mindful of the fact that we do nothing without you. We don't exist without you. We don't live without you. We don't breathe without you. But more importantly, we don't go to work without you, because you gave us our job. We can't pay bills or get food because you were the one who provided that money and the food we bought. Our relationships aren't done by us. They exist because you chose them to. They exist because you and your will happen in our lives. God, please help us to understand this humbleness that you have asked us to have, to allow you to be in control of our hearts, of our lives, knowing that you want to give us so much more than we could ever choose here on earth. Please help us focus on the fact that when we are talking, when we're doing things, our actions are completely reflective of you, God. That there's so many other people watching us and watching what we do, that even though we can't get the gospel to live through them, that is you, that our actions certainly speak volumes to them, and how they think about Christians, how they think about church, how they think about you, God, and how they think about the Bible. God, we're not adequate. We're not sufficient. There's nothing we can do without you. Please keep it in our hearts, God, that we need to keep you close to us, always and completely allowing you to guide our lives and to lead us in the direction that you want us to go. It's only with you that we become sufficient. In your Son's name, I pray. Amen.